Continuing the example where most consumers are uncomfortable with drone delivery, we started with the p-value method, and now we move on to the critical value method. Steps 1 through 5 are the same as the p-value method. You write the claim and its opposite in symbol form, the null and alternative hypotheses, then you determine your significance level. Step 6 is to calculate the test statistic, and it is found to be z equals 2.55. With the critical value method, we now find the critical values. This is a right-tailed test, so the area of the critical region is an area of alpha is 0.05 in the right tail. Refer to table A2 and apply the methods of section 6.1. You'll find that the critical value is z is equal to 1.645, which is at the boundary of the critical region. Step 7, because the test statistic does fall within the critical region, we reject the null hypothesis. Drawing on the next slide. In this picture, you'll notice that the critical value is 1.645. The test statistic is z is equal to 2.55, which does fall in the critical region. Because we rejected H sub O, p is equal to 0.5, then we conclude that there is sufficient sample evidence to support the claim that most, which is more than half, consumers are uncomfortable with drone delivery. We will focus mainly on the p-value method in this particular section. Finding the number of successes x. When using technology for hypothesis tests of proportions, we must usually enter the sample size n and the number of successes x. But in real applications, the sample proportion p hat is often given instead of x. The number of successes x can be found by evaluating x is equal to n times p hat. Note that in the next example, the result of 5587.712 adults must be rounded to the nearest whole number of 5588. A study of sleepwalking or nocturnal wandering was described in Neurology magazine, and it included information that 29.2% of 19,136 American adults have sleepwalked. What is the actual number of adults who have sleepwalked? The number of adults who have sleepwalked is 29.2% of 19,136, or 0.292 times 19,136 equals 5,587.712. But the result must be a whole number, so we round the product to the nearest whole number of 5,588. Here's an example. Fewer than 30% of adults have sleepwalked. Using the same sleepwalking data from the previous example, where n was 19,136 and p hat is 29.2%, would a reporter be justified in stating that fewer than 30% of adults have sleepwalked? Let's use a 0.05 significance level to test the claim that for the adult population, the proportion of those who have sleepwalked is less than 0.30. Requirement check. The sample does appear to be a simple random sample. Fixed number of trials, 19,136. They're independent with two categories. They sleepwalked or they didn't. The requirements to have the normal approximation are satisfied as shown here in number 3. And so we proceed with our technique. Step 1 is the original claim is expressed in symbol form as p is less than 0.30. The opposite is p is greater than or equal to 0.30. Because p is less than 0.30 does not contain equality, it becomes h sub 1, and you see here at the bottom of the screen h sub 0 and h sub 1. The significance level alpha is 0.05. Because the claim involves the proportion p, the statistic relevant to this test is the sample proportion p hat, and the sampling distribution of sample proportions can be approximated by the normal distribution. We use table A2 and proceed as follows to conduct the hypothesis test using the p-value method. We calculate z to be negative 2.41 as shown at the bottom of the screen. It's a left-tailed test, so the p-value is the area to the left of the test statistic. Using table A2, we see that the area to the left of z is negative 2.41 is 0.0080, so the p-value is 0.0080. Step 7, because the p-value is less than or equal to the significance level of 0.05, we reject the null hypothesis. Because we reject the null hypothesis, we support the alternative hypothesis. Therefore, our final conclusion is that there is sufficient evidence to support the claim that fewer than 30% of adults have sleepwalked. Example number 2, store checkout scanner accuracy. In a study of store checkout scanners, 1,234 items were checked for pricing accuracy, 20 checked items were found to be overcharges, and 1,214 were not overcharges. This is based on data provided by the author. Use the p-value method and a 0.05 significance level to test the claim that with scanners, 1% of sales are overcharges. Before scanners were used, the overcharge rate was estimated to be about 1%. Based on these results, do scanners appear to help consumers avoid overcharges? So let's do this problem together. We are asked to use the p-value method to test the claim that with scanners, 1% of sales are overcharges. So my first step is to write the claim and its opposite in symbol form. The claim is that with scanners, 1% of sales are overcharges. So 1% of sales, we're talking about a proportion. So 1% of sales would be P is equal to 0.01. The opposite of that would be P is not equal to 0.01. And if I then write H sub O and H sub 1, remember that H sub O gets the statement with the condition of equality. So this would be where my claim ends up. And the opposite will either have the is not equal to, is less than or equal to, or strictly greater than or equal to symbols. Those are our choices for H sub 1 or the alternative hypothesis. Then I determine the significance level. The significance level is given to me as 0.05. This is a sample, so we're testing a claim about a proportion. So I should have p hat, I would think. So p hat is going to be, now what am I testing? That 1% of sales are overcharges. And in my sample, I have this is my n. 1,234 and 20 were found to be overcharges, so that's my x. So p hat as x over n is going to be 20 over 1,234. I'm using the p-value method, and my calculated test statistic is z sub c is equal to p hat minus p over the square root of pq divided by n. So I've got to find q. I know p is here. P is equal to 0.01. So q would be 0.99. So z sub c is equal to p hat, which is 20 over 1,234, minus p, which is 0.01. P is right here. And that's divided by the square root of p, which is 0.01, times q, which is 0.99. Remember, p and q add up to 1. And that's divided by n, which is 1,234. Therefore, z sub c, after you do that number crunching, if you did your calculation correctly, z should be equal to 2.19. The next step in my process, since I'm using the p-value method, is to find the area associated with a z of 2.19. Remember, this is the calculated test statistic. So I draw my figure, Placing my z is equal to 2.19. I want to find the area associated with a z of 2.19. So I look up in my formulas and charts packet on the positive z-score table, 2.19, which is 0.9857, but that's the area from here to the left, 0.9857. To find the area of the shaded region, I deduct that from 1, which is going to give me an area of 0.0143. Now, since this is a two-tailed test, notice that the h sub 1 is a not equal to. This is a two-tailed test. In order to find the correct p-value, I actually need to double this number. So my p-value is going to be 2 × 0.0143, or 0.0286. That's my p-value. It's a two-tailed test. The next thing that I do is I compare my p-value to the significance level. So I find that my p-value is less than or equal to alpha, because 0.0286 is less than or equal to alpha. Therefore, I reject H sub O, so I'm going to reject the null hypothesis, and that leads me to determining what my final conclusion is going to be. So if I go back and look at H sub O and H sub 1, H sub O was P is equal to 0.01, which is where my claim was. H sub 1 is equal to P is equal, not equal to 0.01. If I write my conclusion, I can actually use the chart in the formula and charts packet to kind of get myself started on the final sentence that I'm going to write for my conclusion. And there's a flow chart in here. The flow chart is located on one of these pages, and it basically walks me through the determination of how to begin the sentence to write the final conclusion. So does the original claim contain the condition of equality? Did we decide that? The original claim, yes, does contain the condition of equality. Did I reject H sub O? Yes, I rejected H sub O. And because I did reject H sub O, then I can begin my sentence as there is sufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the claim.